Hi everyone, welcome to episode 2. So today we're going to begin programming our noise map generation. We're going to be using perlin noise for the series, since Unity provides a built-in implementation of it in their maths class. One thing to take note of with perlin noise, however, is that at integral coordinates, we're always going to get the same value. This isn't going to pose a problem, but it is good just to be aware of it. Alright, so in this new Unity project, let's head over to the scripts folder. And let's create a new C# script called noise. So if we just open this up, we're not going to need to apply this to any object in our scene, so we have no reason to inherit from mono behavior. Also, we're not going to want to make multiple instances of the script, so we can just go ahead and make it static. All right, so we want this to have a method for generating a noise map, and we want that to return essentially a grid of values between 0 and 1. So let's create a public static method returning a 2D array of float values, and we can call this method generateNoiseMap. So ultimately it's going to have a whole bunch of arguments, including the lacunarity and persistence values we talked about last episode, but for now let's just define the map dimensions as an int for the map width, and another int for the map height. So we can now create our 2D float array called our noise map, set that equal to a new 2D float array with a size of map width by map height, and we'll want to loop through that noise map. So we'll say for int y equals 0, y less than map height, y plus plus. And similarly for the x value, for int x equals 0, x less than map width, x plus plus. So we'll now want to figure out at which points we'll be sampling our height values from. So let's say float sample x. Let's just set this equal to x for now. And then float sample y, we can set to y. Of course, we don't want to just use these integer values, since as I mentioned earlier, that will give us the same value every time. So let's introduce a new argument, a float for the scale of the noise, and we can just divide x by scale and also y by scale so that we get some nice non-integer values. Now, of course, we have to be careful that if scale is 0, we're going to get a division by 0 error. So let's just handle that case by saying if the scale is less than or equal to 0, then we can just clamp it to a minimum value of, say, 0.0001. All right, so now that we have our sample coordinates, we can say float perlin value is equal to mathf.perlin, and we'll pass in sample x and sample y. We just need to now apply that to our noise map. So we can say noise map with coordinates x and y is equal to that perlin value. Finally, of course, we just need to return the noise map that we've just created. Now, obviously, there's a lot more work we need to do on our generate noise map method, but I'd first like to get it drawn onto the screen so that we can sort of visualize what we're working with. So let's head back to Unity, and I'm going to create another C# script, this one called map generator, and I want to apply that to an object in the scene. So let's create a new empty, and we can just call this map generator as well. Just reset that so it's in the center of the scene, and apply the map generator script to it. So in here, we'll want to have a bunch of values defining our map, such as, later on, lacunarity and persistence, but for now just public int map width, public int map height, and also that float for the noise scale. All right, then we'll want to have a public void. We'll call this generate map. And what it'll start out by doing is just fetching the 2D noise map from the noise class. So we can say 2D float array, call this noise map, is equal to noise.generateNoiseMap, and we can pass in all these parameters, map width, map height, and noise scale. So later on, of course, we'll have a bunch of stuff over here to sort of process this noise map to turn it into our terrain map. But for now, we just want to pass it along to our map display class so that it can draw this noise map to the screen. So let's hop back to Unity and create this map display class that I've been talking about. So just call this map display, and we can apply that to the map generator object in our scene as well. So this is just going to take the noise map and it's going to turn it into a texture, and then it's going to apply that texture to a plane in our scene. So let's create a new plane game object, and I'm just going to reset that once again so it's in the center. You can just remove the collider, and let's now go to our map display. So we're going to want a reference to the renderer of that plane so that we can set its texture. So let's say public renderer, we can call that our texture renderer. And then we're going to want to have a public method called something like drawNoiseMap, which takes in that 2D float array for the noise map. And what we'll first want to do is just figure out the width and height of the noise map that we've been given. So we can do this by saying int width equals noisemap.getLength 0 for the first dimension, and then int height equals noisemap.getLength 1 for the second dimension. Now we can create our 2D texture by saying texture2D, just call this texture is equal to a new 2D texture with a width of width, and you guessed it, a height of height. So we now want to go ahead and set the color of each of the pixels in this texture. So one way to do that would be to say texture.setPixel, and then we can pass in a x and y coordinate as well as a color. But it turns out it's faster to first generate an array of all of the colors for all of the pixels, and then to just set them all at once like so. So we'll choose that method instead. So let's create a color array, call this our color map, set that equal to a new color array with a size of width multiplied by the height, and then we'll want to loop through all of the values in our noise map. So we can just say for int y equals 0, y less than height, y plus plus. Once again, same thing for x, for int x equals 0, x less than width, x incrementing by 1 each time. We now want to set color map. We need to, of course, figure out the index for the color map. Remember that the color map is a one-dimensional array, whereas our noise map is a two-dimensional array. So we can get the index by first multiplying y by the width of the map. So that will give us the index of the sort of row that we're currently on. And then to get the column, we of course just add the x value. So we want to set this equal to a color somewhere between black and white, depending on the value of the noise map at that point. So we can say color.lerp from color A equals color.black to color B equals color.white. And then we give it a percentage between 0 and 1, which is the same range as our noise map, which is convenient. So we just say noise map with an index of x and y. Okay, so we want to apply those colors to our texture. So we say texture.setPixels, pass in the color map, and then just apply everything we've done by saying texture.apply. Okay, so we'll now want to apply the texture to the texture renderer. One thing to note is that we don't always want to have to enter game mode in order to sort of preview our maps. It would be much nicer if we could generate them inside of the editor. So that means that we can't use texture-renderer.material, since that is only instantiated at runtime. So instead, we must use shared material. So we can set the shared material's main texture equal to the texture we've just generated. And it'll also be nice to set the size of the plane to the same size as the map. So we can just say texture renderer dot transform.localScale is equal to a new vector 3 with an x size of width, a y size of 1, and a z size of height. All right, let's save that. And let's go into the map generator class so that we can call the map display with our noise map. So we need to get a reference to the map display, of course. So let's just say map display, call that display, is equal to find object of type map display. And then we can say display dot draw noise map and just pass in the noise map. Oops. Noise map. All right, let's go back into Unity and let's apply the plane to here. And let's also create a material for this plane. So I'm going to create a new folder to store materials in. And we can just create a new one over here. Just call this something like map material. Okay. And I'm going to set this equal to a unlit texture shader, since we don't have a light in our scene currently. And I can just apply that over there. All right, so at the moment, there's no way for the map generator's generate map method to be called. So what we're going to do is create a editor script so that we'll have a little button over here to generate the map within the editor. So let's create a editor folder, and inside of that we'll create a new C# script, and we can call this something like map generator editor. Alright, let's open that up, and we'll start off by saying using Unity editor, and then we'll extend from editor instead of mono behavior, and we can delete all of this stuff and instead just override the onInspector GUI method. Okay, now let's start off by getting a reference to our map generator. So we can do that by saying map generator, let's just call that map gen, is equal to target, which is the object that this custom editor is inspecting. And we just want to cast that object to a map generator. So we can just add in brackets before it, map generator, like so. All right, then let's draw the default inspector. So we can just say draw default inspector. And then we'll want to add in a button, and we'll say if that button is pressed. So the button is GUI layout dot button with some text, say just generate. If that button is pressed, we'll say map gen dot generate map. Okay, so let's go into Unity, and we want to make sure that our map has a width and a height, otherwise the texture is going to break and potentially crash Unity. That's happened to me once or twice. So let's give this a width of 10, a height of 10, and a noise scale of say 0.3. The button isn't actually showing up at the moment, which is just a little something I forgot. We need to say over here that this is a custom editor, and we have to say that the type of class that it is a custom editor of is the map generator class. Okay, so now we should see that generate button popping up. So if we press generate, we now get this nice perlin map. Let's increase the size to 100 by 100. Let's perhaps add in an option for the map generator to auto update whenever we change one of these values. So let's create a public bool in the map generator class. Public bool auto update. And what the map generator editor will do is it will say if draw default inspector, which just means if any value was changed, then if mapgen.autoupdate, then we'll also generate the map. Okay, so now if we turn on auto update and increase the scale, we should see that automatically updating. I'm going to end here for this episode. I hope you've enjoyed, and until next time, cheers.